Man, young woman, wherever you are at, I believe that you're keeping safe in this time and season. Glory to God, and that you're being blessed by, you know, our Tuesday night hangout. Our Tuesday nights are no longer boring. Glory to God. We have something to share. We have something to talk about. And I believe that you're having a wonderful time of prayer, of praise and worship and connecting. And the word has been a blessing to you and me. Glory to God. Now, let me tell you, we are in a situation. We are in a fix. We are at a place, man, we cannot turn, you know, to the left or the right. We don't know where to turn to. We don't know where to go. And our patience is running thin. And fear is creeping in because you're thinking, what do I do? I cannot go to work. Where do I get my meals? You know, all the stuff. And you're wondering, where will help come from? I would love to welcome Pastor Randy this moment to lead us in a, you know, focused prayer for a few minutes, even as we pray for the grace of God to help us sustain, you know, to help, to keep us during this time of the COVID-19 and the pandemic and the pressures of life in the nation. Name of Jesus. Pastor Ranji, take us through the prayers. Glory to God. Amen.
Well, praise the Lord. It's such an honor and a privilege to be able to be with you guys today, even though it's via the internet. But all the same, we still give God the glory, for He has given us at least a platform where we can be able to meet together, even though not physically together. You know, in 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1, the apostle says something. He said, in the last days, perilous times shall come. And that word perilous is simply talking about hard times, severe times. And for most of us right now, you are kind of getting the feel of the hardness of life. Because I know there are many that are not able to go to work. There are many that have lost their job, so the income is not coming. And even for those who are still living with your parents, I know most of the parents right now are stressed because of the stress that they're getting from work, the stress that they're getting from their jobs. Maybe even for them, they have been told that they won't be receiving their salaries. So there's all these pressures of life that are coming. And I know for most of our youth, church, the gathering of believers to you was bringing comfort and solace, because that's the time that you got to be able to run away from the problems, at least even if for a couple of hours, just to go somewhere and be edified and feel strengthened, because stress your home now, pia ni mingi, or the environment in which you live in. Maybe where you're living in is not a conducive environment, and the people around you are doing drugs, you know, all these things that happen. Tunajua kenye wendelea mta. So coming to church was bringing so much comfort, but now you have to be there and be a light where you are. So I just feel in my heart, even we are feeling together with Pastor Joe, that we should really take this time to pray for you, that God will strengthen you so that your faith will not fail. Then God will give you an idea of how to be a light where you are, how to bring solutions where you are, and that you are not going to be overwhelmed. So let us just take this time and pray together. Amen. So join me in prayer so that God will strengthen us. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you all the praise, we give you all the glory, we honor you, my God. There is no other but you. We recognize you as our Father, we recognize you as our Provider, we recognize you as Jireh, we recognize you as our Nourisher, my God. Lord, even with all that is going on in this time, my Lord, we thank you because you are our strength. Our strength is not in the economy, my God, but our strength is in you, because we know that you are the Provider, my Lord. Lord, we commit our parents to you, my God. We commit our siblings to you, my God. Lord, you've told us to put all your cares upon you. for you care for us, my God. Therefore, Lord, we put all our cares upon you, my God, and we ask you to strengthen us in our inner man, Lord, that none of our faith will fail, my God, that all of us will come out of this stronger, my God, that all of us will come out of this, my God, strengthened, that our trust will be cemented in you, that we are going to be rooted and grounded in you, my God. Lord, I thank you for each and every one of us, my God, for your grace is upon us. I thank you for your loving kindness is towards us, and I thank you for your provision, my Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 Yes, the grace of God, the grace of God in this time. Oh my goodness, thank you, Jesus. We are going to make it. We shall, oh my goodness, we will get to the other side of all this situation, and everything will pass away. But we pray that the, you know, the word of the Lord and the grace of God shall keep us even to that time in the name of Jesus. Right now, I would love to welcome us to another wonderful moment of praise and worship. Glory to God. Get yourself ready, because we are about to, you know, to bring the hearts down in praising and glorifying the Lord. Why? Because He is a good God. Come on, raise up some praises. Come on, celebrate the goodness of the Lord even in this time and in this season. Karibu sana Felista, as you take us through this wonderful moment in the name of Jesus. Yeah!
Thank you so much, Pastor Joe, for that session. Wherever you are, get up on your feet and let us praise God the best way we know. Hallelujah. Yeah. Come on, clap your hands to Jesus. Woo! Come on.
Mungu kama wewe papa Hakuna Mungu kama wewe papa Hakuna Mungu kama wewe papa Hakuna Mungu kama wewe papa Come on, let's dance!
Yeah. One more time!
Mungu kama wewe papa Hakuna Mungu kama wewe papa Hakuna Mungu kama wewe papa Hakuna Mungu kama wewe papa Oh wa ushindi wa ushindi Wa ushindi Mungu baba
Kama siho wewe ni mwabudu nani
into a time of worship, just raise your hands and tell the Lord how much you love Him and how much you adore Him. Give Him your praises, give Him your worship, give Him your love, everyone. Just tell Him how much you love Him and how much you adore Him. Just pray to Him, tell him everything that you want to tell Him. Tell Him you love Him, tell Him He's amazing, tell Him He's awesome, tell Him He's great to you.
Jesus, you're the cup.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy of all praise. You are worthy of all adoration, Lord, because you have not left us. O King of glory, you are on our side. You're watching over us and taking care of us. In the name of Jesus, we praise and we glorify you and we worship. Amen. Come on, somebody. Say amen. Wow. Thank you, Jesus. Now, even as we go on, I want to bring the word of the Lord really quickly to us. And I believe that, you know, God, the word of God is there for us to live by. Jesus said that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of the Father. And let me tell you, once we take the word of God and we walk in it, oh my goodness, we are set up for success. Glory to God. Tonight, I want us to talk about something. And this comes in a form of a question. How prepared are you? How prepared are you? Prepared for what? Prepared for the situation and the next season after this pandemic and the pressures of life is past. How prepared are you for the life after COVID-19? How prepared are you for life after when things have resumed? How prepared are you after, you know, when the holiday is done? How prepared are you for what is coming your way? And our text today comes from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 34 to 36. Now listen, this is a story of a man we love talking about. The man is Mr. David. Yes, David the king, David the giant slayer, the giant killer. Glory to God. Listen to what the Bible says. But David said to Saul, "Your servant was tending his father's sheep when a lion or a bear came and took a lamb from the flock. I went out after him and attacked him and rescued it from his mouth. And when he rose," now the lion or the bear, "when he rose against me, I seized him by his hand and struck him and killed him." Verse 36 says, "Your servant has killed both the lion and the bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine will be like one of them, since he has taunted the armies of God." Wow. So let me paint it this way. David, you know, his father sent him, "Go check out on your brothers, see how they are, take this food to them." And when he went there, he found that these guys are in a stalemate. They are not doing any, yani, there's a giant standing on this side, then the armies of the Lord of Israel are standing on this other side, and no one is going. And this Goliath is saying, send me a man, someone he can fight with me. And David looked and he asked, why are you not doing this? Why is no one going to fight this guy, you know? And they're saying, how can you go fight again with such a massive, you know, humongous a giant? And the Bible describes how Goliath was even clothed, that even his spear, someone carried his spear for him. Man, this guy was ready, this giant was ready to kill, but there was no one from there, you know, from the army of Israel who was ready to go and face him, because they felt in their heart, if we go out, this guy is going to kill us. He's actually going to do what he says. And David was like, no, I think I can take this guy. And he goes to the king and tells the king, "King, I wanna go and fight this guy. This guy cannot be abusing the armies of the Lord like that. He cannot do that. I am ready to take him down." And so when he, you know, Saul asked him, "So David, you're just a young man. How are you even sure that you're going to kill him? I think even his friends were like, David, you can't do that. This guy is going to kill you." But guess what? David was ready. He told the king, "King, listen, I have been tending to my father's sheep. But besides tending to my father's sheep, I have been getting ready. I have been practicing. I know how to fight. I can do this. This guy, I can do it." Why? Because when the lion came and they attacked my father's sheep. When the bear came and they attacked my father's sheep, I was ready. I killed them. And this Philistine, he's just like one of those lions. I'm not afraid. Send me out because I am ready to fight. Because I am ready for what is coming. I don't believe that David was in the wilderness taking care of his father's sheep and getting ready to kill Goliath. He never knew that Goliath was coming, but he was getting himself ready. He knew that he had to protect the sheep and he was ready. Listen, what are you doing in this time and season? David was in the wilderness. Nobody knew about him. Nobody really cared about him. He was tending sheep while his brothers were fighting, you know, but he was there practicing. Probably the greatest motivation were his brothers, wakiinua hizo machuma, eh? You know, when they are practicing and doing all those fights, David was there and watching them. And then when he goes into the wilderness, he's practicing and he was getting himself ready. But oh my goodness, listen, he got ready and he killed Goliath. So tonight I'm asking you, how prepared are you? Because this situation is going to end. The pandemic is going to end. And we are going to go back to how life was? Or are we going to be better versions of who we are? Listen, number one, for us to prepare ourselves in this season, make sure you're not wasting your time. Don't waste your time. Don't waste this time. Don't say, oh, don't lament with the people when they're lamenting. No, young man, young woman, don't be there lamenting. What should you do? Number one, kill your old habits. Najua kuna wengi sahi wana watch my series. It's series again and again and again. Yani from morning to evening. Nothing else you're doing. Please, please, please. Don't not waste your time. Kill the bad habits in your life. Whatever bad habits and you don't want to carry it into the next life, into the next season of your life, please kill it now. Kill it now. Glory to God. Listen to what the Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 12 verse 2. It says, and do not be conformed to the likeness of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Amen. What am I saying? Please, the old habits, the things that are going on in the world that are not profitable to you, that are taking your life down, you know them. Kill them in the name of Jesus. Kill them completely. Second one is invest. Invest on what is profitable. And wisdom is profitable. Invest on what is profitable. Listen to what the Bible says. The Bible says, also, the plans of the diligent lead to profit, as surely as haste leads to poverty. Proverbs chapter 2 verse 15. If you sit and plan well, if you sit and calculate and see, when this is done, this is where I want to be. If you plan well, my goodness, you're going to succeed. But if you wait and get into the next season and think, oh, I'm going to do it, I can make it, I've been doing this before, my friend, you can't wing it. You're going to suffer. Actually, you're going to stagnate and start dying. Listen to what the Bible says. A wise man thinks ahead. A wise man thinks ahead. Take your time. Think what you want to do after all this is done. But listen to what the Bible says. A wise man thinks ahead, a fool doesn't, and even brags about it. Don't be the fool, man. Don't be a fool. Plan ahead. Think ahead. Don't see the situation around here. Think ahead. The other thing, the Bible also says in Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6 to 8, that go to the ant, you sluggard. Consider its ways and be wise. It has no commander, nor overseer or ruler, yet it stores its provision in summer and gathers its food at harvest, because it knows winter is coming. Nobody tells it. It gets ready when the sun is shining. It goes and gathers food and stores. Wow. What a wonderful truth. It goes and gathers food and stores because it knows autumn is, winter is coming. The cold season is coming when we will not be able to go out and look for food. Let us store. My goodness. Be wise. Plan. Think ahead. Do not waste your time. The last thing is that, build yourself in the Lord. Build yourself in the Lord. Listen to what the Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 17, that command those who are rich in this present world not to be arrogant, not to put their hope in wealth, which is so uncertain, but to put their hope in God, for who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment. brothers and sisters. There are people who are building, you know, their lives around money. They are building their lives around things that are unsure, things that are not promising them the future. And so I'm asking you, please, 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 in this season, build yourself in the Lord. Invest in prayer. Invest in reading the word. Invest in books about God and the knowledge of God. And I tell you, when this pandemic is done, when this season is done, you will be a conqueror. Listen to what the Bible says in the book of Luke, chapter 14 and verse 28 to 34. For which of you, intending to build a tower, does not sit down first and count the cost, whether he has enough to finish it, lest after he has laid the foundation and is not able to finish, all who sees it begin to mock him, saying, this man began to build and was not able to finish. We have projects, we have ideas, we have things that we want to do. Oh my goodness. But the only way we will be able to walk in success after the pandemic is done, after this season is done, is when we choose to build ourselves in the Lord. Build ourselves in the Lord. Invest in the right foundation. Remember, how prepared are you? David was prepared. He was in the wilderness. He was motivated. He was practicing. He killed the lion. He killed the bear. But how did he do it? He was ready. And when he faced Goliath, oh my, it never took him long. It just took him one stone and one slingshot, and Goliath was dead. Your success is coming, but you have to be ready. Prepare yourself in this season, and God bless you. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, thank you for this season, that as a young man and young woman, we will not waste time. King of glory, all the bad habits, we are throwing them off the window in the name of Jesus. Anything that never worked for us, King of glory, but we are throwing it out the window in the name of Jesus. Oh, King of glory, we are praying that help us, my Father, to renew our minds on a daily basis, King of glory, so that we can be able to invest on that which is profitable, to get wisdom and to get knowledge in this season, in the name of Jesus, to be able to plan ahead, oh, King of glory, and also, my Father, to have a solid foundation in Christ Jesus, in the Word of God, in prayer, in fellowship with the Holy Spirit, because, Lord, we know if we do this, that King of glory, we are on the path of success. Help us, my Father, by the Holy Spirit, and in this season, in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen. Remember, how prepared are you? Get ready for what is coming by killing the bad habits, by investing on what is profitable, and thinking ahead and planning ahead and investing yourself and building yourself in the Lord. And you shall be on the road to success. You know what Goliath did? Ali Dedi, Naivo Ivo, and David became the hero. Glory to God. Amen and amen. Oh yeah, glory to God. Amen and amen. I believe that you're blessed and that you have had a wonderful time. Glory to God. And you are getting yourself ready. But even as we come to the end tonight of our hangout, I would love to remind you that we are taking tallies. We're still going through the challenges that you guys have sent in, and we will be announcing the winner very soon. But now, as we leave, we want to share the testimonials of, you know, people. What are they doing in this season, and where are they at? And be blessed, and may the Lord bless you and keep you. See you next Tuesday. Amen and amen and amen. Shalom.
Hey, hey, praise the Lord. How are you guys doing? My name is Pastor Donna from Destiny Chapel. I'm here with my wife, Jen. Or I would say, let me call her my madam, my madame. You know, people usually think that I'm a Congolese, so the Congolese, they usually say, my madame, 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 madame. So I'm here with my madame, and we are at church.
Yes.
And I know most of you have been saying, oh, we are missing church, we are missing church. As guys, as you can see, our life is just in church. We are just in church every day, like every day. So we are just hanging out here, you know, doing some recordings here and there to make sure that you are, you know, you are blessed every day. Make sure that you worship the Lord as usual. And so we thank God for the gift of life. We're just here hanging out. And I just want to pose a challenge to you, to just let you know that this is a season where I think most of us should take time and just get more intimate with the Lord at your home. Just take some moment and just get to know God more and more and more. And that is what basically even us guys, we are doing in this season. We've just gotten the opportunity to get to know God deeper and deeper and get more intimate with Him in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you.
Bless you.
Say something, my madam.
We miss you so much. I look forward to seeing you guys. I love you. And I look forward to seeing you soon.
Thank you, madam.
How are you doing, my people? I've been told to say, how are you doing, my people? Are you doing well? I am also doing well. Anyway, hi, guys. How are you doing? Jimo here, or Pastor Jimo, as many people call me. And just giving out a shout out to you guys. I don't know what you're up to in this season. Personally, my life has not changed. I wake up in the morning as usual, 3 a.m. I'm up. By 5, I'm in the studio. Life continues as normal. But I realize for quite a number of people, maisha imebadilika, and you find that you have a lot of time in your hands. I was thinking about this. Imagine if you had a lot of money in your hands, what would you do with it? I think it's exactly the same thing you're doing with your time in this season. If you're squandering your time, see my popcorn, see my movie, see my series, see my tabia zingine, see as you mentioned, kuna watu hapa in the background. If that's what you're engaging in, it means that if somebody gave you a lot of money suddenly, you would use it on useless things. I think last week, Pastor Joe was preaching to us about David in the wilderness and his season in the wilderness when he killed the lion and he killed the bear. He was all alone, no one with him, no one knew about it. But without that season, the season for Goliath would not have happened for him. It is what you do in your season in the wilderness when you're all alone that prepares you for the season that elevates you and promotes you. Jesus is taken into the wilderness, led by the Holy Spirit to be tempted of the devil. He overcomes, he comes back, he begins his public ministry in the limelight, he is elevated. So the question is, in this season where we are only seeing each other on Viusasa, what are you doing with your time? Are you building yourself up? Unajua mse, hii time ungekuwa ulianza kupiga rodi ama kuenda gym. By the time tunarudi church, ungekuwa maze uko mundu strong, umeshona. Lakini kama ni mabaga na sijui manini, utakamna ka six-pack kamefichwa, kamekuwa well-insulated. What am I saying? I'm simply saying the thing you do with your time now will either make you enter into the next season with victory or miss out on the opportunity that the next season avails for you. Ni hayo tu. One of the things I miss about church ni chai. Mi ni mluya. Matentu ni wambio kweli. After service, kachai pale inje, kugotea wase, you know, just interacting with people, tumadadhi. Unakumbuka tule tumadadhi to pale inje. Samosas I still eat at home, but tule tumadadhi to pale inje is something I also miss. Interacting with people, one of the things I've really missed is greeting people and hugging people. Me, I like hugging people. That one I've really missed. When we come back to church, if I hug you, don't pull back. I will be compensating for all the hugs I've missed for these weeks we have been away from each other. Some of the people I've missed Bazo. Bazo we waga unalibamba sana. I've missed you. Boaz, my good friend. You know, when I see you, I see a miracle. I've really, really missed you. I've missed everybody at Destiny. Looking forward to what God is doing in the next season. Make sure you prepare yourself. I'm talking too much. I need to shut my mouth and go home. Have a great day. God bless you.